So, with everything that's been talked about, I want to ask two questions back to back, and I want simple answers mostly from everybody, and then we can talk more about it. But we'll go left to right quickly, okay? I would have done this with everyone else, but Fringy has said he's going to need a few more hours before the power's going back on, so it's likely he won't be able to be back before the end. But I'll give you his answer anyway, because I asked him what it would be. But yeah, so I guess Mark, you can go first. Which game's better? Which game do you prefer slash would play like first if you were to revisit Resident Evil 4?
Ooh, I don't know. I think that probably going forward, I will want to revisit Resident Evil, OG Resident Evil 4 on Steam Deck. Like, because I've now played it twice on my Steam Deck. It actually sort of plays perfectly there. Because I think it must be Linux compatible, because I have a plugin that actually tells you what the real compatibility is with the Steam Deck thing, because Steam has sort of a three-tiered system, but Platinum only gets given to games that actually run natively on Linux. So, I mean, I guess that does run well enough that there's a place where I have it always, that I can always fire it up. It runs at 60 FPS and plays totally fine. And probably when I feel like playing Resident Evil 4 with the mouse keyboard and a whole big high-powered PC, I'll probably play the remake. And I think that'd be a good way to preserve both experiences in their own setting, you know?
Alrighty. My answer, I think, is that by my standards that can get very rigid about what I believe to be like superior when it comes to design of video games, one or the other, I'm probably gonna go with OG Resident Evil 4. I think it's more consistent and tight, and more to celebrate in terms of how well designed I think it is. This game, however, in terms of design, there's plenty to compliment, even praise over the original in terms of changes they've made. I find there's more to be critical of, and not only is there more to be critical of, but there are elements that are basically throughout the game, as opposed to like, I don't like this boss or this particular thing. It's like, oh, that mechanic's just throughout, and it's like actively damaged a significant portion of a thing. While at the same time, I think they're both fantastic. As for which I prefer and which one I go back to, not sure I can answer that yet. I'm really not sure. It might be something that in a year from now, when I think about playing Resident Evil 4, is when I'll decide, and I'll realize which one is the one that I'd rather either play first or play over the other. I really love both of them, and I will say it's quite a pull, this game, the graphical element to it. Way cooler to play a game that's this, fucking advanced in terms of how everything looks. So it could be that that's what edges out the original, the new. I'm not entirely sure. I'm gonna have to answer that when the time comes. Metal, what do you say?
I also both like them very, very much. I can just echo the consistency part on the OG for sure. Just in terms of mechanics, it's just solid and very, very good. I think in my mind, I'm probably just gonna go with both when I want to replay. So probably if I decide to go, I want to replay RE4, I might just do a package dealio.
Concurrently, yeah.
Just go with first the OG and then a playthrough of the remake. Because I do like them both very much. But yeah, that's my answer, I think.
All
I
right,
don't know if I,
and
you know.
Rags.
So Mahler's thoughts are very similar to mine. The Resident Evil 4, the original, has a special place in my heart. And I do think that it is a better game. It is, I think, just more consistent, mechanically tight. However, as for which one I'll play going into the future, it's tough to say because I've put significantly less hours into this one. So I'll probably be playing this one if I want Resident Evil 4 for a while to come because I've played the original so much. There's so much to appreciate about the new one. It looks great. There's a lot of good changes. There's some not so good changes. There's a lot of great changes that I really, really enjoy. So yeah, I think I'd still say the original is the better game mechanically, but there's so much to like about this new one, and it does so much well that I will definitely be playing it for or into the future.
Fringy's answer
But and
was the OG is a better game based on consistent design, but I prefer the remake. I think I prefer the remake, is what he said. It's just a reflection of how things work, I guess. It could be better designed mechanically or a tighter story or whatever. Because I actually think that the story wins out in the new game compared to the old.
It does, yeah. Yes.
If there's going to be a mod that's going to replace the aiming with all laser sights.
Well, I was just about to mention that. Someone messaged me during the, or someone in chat had mentioned it earlier. Apparently on Nexus mods, there's a mod that gives every gun the laser sight, and it adds the consistent staggering back in.
Oh boy.
So if that's the case, then I'll be very, very interested to try that out.
Man, I wanted to take a break from streaming tomorrow, but now I want to download that and do a playthrough of that.
Yeah, you might want to maybe tag some of us in the Discord later if you have a link to that mod.
Yeah, that would be great.
Because like legitimately, I think like the perfect mix of if this new game had the laser sight and the consistent staggering, it would be like they would just take it to that top tier and make it incredible. So give us a ping later with that.
Was it that's cheating? Really yes. Yes, it is.
Yes, yes. Mods, yeah. Mods are all cheating and some of them are wonderful.
Well, I mean, the laser sight just makes the game, I mean, in a way, it's a complicated talk. It gets technically easier and harder at the same time, but it just depends.
Why would it make it harder?
It's harder to like aim with at a target with a red dot than it is just an out of universe like
that's
reticle.
I see what you're saying is like, so say you had a big circle, it's like that's easy to get on a target compared to a red dot. However, that big circle doesn't guarantee you'll get the shot, right?
It's a bit of both, but the red dot is technically more difficult to use, but it's more consistent and it will lead to better rewards if you are a good shot.
Once you have the indication of a hit with the red dot sight, it's 100%. Have that circle.
Well, that's what we
or
want.
Not. No, I'm on the same team.
Maybe,
in that regard. In fact, I honestly think that if now that we've got, granted, a totally broken, at least at this juncture, PC version of The Last of Us, I think it would be really interesting to see if you added the Resident Evil 4 red dot into The Last of Us. Would it make the shooting mechanics good?
Interesting question.
Because it was the crouch in the Resident Evil 4 remake that made me think that. I was like, this feels actually kind of similar to The Last of Us. It's just better. Like, the shooting mechanics are good, as opposed to being shit. And
shooting mechanics are all right. That's not.
Oh, in Last of Us or
in the remake? In the remake,
you think they're you just think they're all right? I think they're pretty tight.
I do not think that they're tight in this. I don't like the random bullet stuff.
I'm talking about crouching. with the red dot. Yeah.
Oh yeah, if you added all that stuff in, then I'd significantly think better of it, and I'd enjoy it more and like it more. Yeah.
Also, basically all of them are saying they're okay with censorship. That happened.
Huh? What?
Censorship? What? If anything, what mods are like the opposite of that.
Yeah,
you can do whatever you want, sort of thing.
Maybe like moderators.
Mods exist outside of censorship.
Oh, shit. If you're talking about the fact that they've covered up Ashley's panties, don't even get me started, dude.
Like, jeez, go outside.
Oh, maybe one thing I did notice as far as that goes is apparently because I learned the term scort when I was doing a review of the Resident Evil 3 remake. It's a skirt that are also shorts. So they're not like... So, but anyways, the reason I learned that term was when I was reviewing Resident Evil 3 remake. That's apparently what they did to Jill Valentine's mini skirt in the classic costume in that game. And I actually just noticed one time when she was climbing up a ladder, I was like, oh, Ashley's kind of kilt, her tartan skirt at the end is a skirt in this game as well.
Well, mm-hmm.
All I know is that
probably a mod for it, okay?
Oh, absolutely. I've seen some Badonkadonk mods already.
There you go. You can get Leon and Ashley doing whatever.
All your characters in this game, don't worry.
There you go.
Ashley's still got her ballistic physics in this one. Out the gate, no mods.
That's true.
I don't know. I think the whole Capcom is taking the sexiness out of thing. I don't buy it.
Well, the I remember people say they've uglified Ashley because of blah, 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 blah. And it's just like, but I mean,
Ashley
no
was
way.
Always okay looking. Calm down.
I think she's fucking better looking at this game. But I was going to say, no way, no way you can maintain that argument across the board when you have Ada and Hunnigan looking the way they do. No way you're telling me they've been uglified.
Yeah,
that ain't happening. Well,
Ada in particular, I was just like, okay, like, say what you will about her voice acting, but nothing wrong with that character model. With Ashley, I think because I almost did notice it at first. I was like, oh, Ashley looks strange when I first saw her. And I think what it is the blonde hair using the sort of RE Engine hair effects, whatever they had, almost looks kind of gray. So when her act one outfit, where I guess not chapter one, but you know, like the first half of the game when she's wearing a coat and something of a scarf and everything, she's dressed more what looks like almost like a Hillary Clinton type outfit. And I think that is a little off-putting when you compare it to the sort of
fucking Salazar looks more like Hillary Clinton than she does. Come on.
I think it's just the idea of it's like she's wearing a blazer and I don't know. I'm not saying that it's necessarily a bad thing. It's just I think that in the second half of the game, she basically just gets her costume from the original. So I was like, where's the problem then? It's like, is that she's wearing a coat at the part of the game when she might be outdoors more? I don't know. I think the argument totally falls apart when it's like they give her the costume you're complaining about her losing in this game. So obviously they weren't trying to get rid of it, you know.
I just see James saying it. It's just funny. They used an IRL cosplayer for the body model, but then slapped someone else's face on the character.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Strange.
Oh wow.
It's really weird.
Man, that cosplayer was probably upset about that.
Maybe they feel complimented about it, that they got it. The body at least got in there. That's something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Anything else you guys want to say about this game in closing?
Oh, no? I think we've said. I've said enough. I'm tired. We've talked about this a long time, and I'm ready to.
I think it's excellent. I think we're winning right now with the whole Dead Space and this. That's a question.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
What's better, this or Dead Space remake?
Oh, I think the Dead Space.
I'd say the Dead Space remake wins out for the same reason.
Compared to their own originals or compared to each other?
I think it's games, I'm trying to say. And I think it wins out for the same reason OG Resident Evil 4 wins out, is that I think the Dead Space remake is much more consistent. It's fucking.
Yeah, I think the way that they expanded on the Dead Space remake was just like, it feels like a different game in a good way. Yeah.
Yeah, and we said it before this game even came out. It was never going to replace Resident Evil 4. It just couldn't. It was only ever going to be able to be, like, different. And it is very different.
Yep.
Because you could theoretically have done it, I guess, with, like, a remaster. But I guess what I'm trying to suggest is that they've fundamentally changed so many things about how everything works that it plays like a completely different game. May look a lot the same and have the same vibe in a lot of different ways. But it's just, they're very much different games. And I love both of them.